past mistakes. I'm blue without your face. Well, what can I do?
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So, let's start off with our skin. I'm using this Ulla Henriksen True Facial Water. I'm gonna mist it all over my face just to prep the skin. This makes it more tacky, so the moisturizers will absorb a little bit faster. And I'm mixing these two moisturizers of the Strobe Cream as well as the Clinique Pep Start. And then with my eye cream, I'm going to use the Clinique Pep Start as well. I'm going to dot it all along my under eye area, and I'm going to blend it up all the way to my brow bone too. Now moving on to my eyebrows, I'm using Benefit's Goof Proof Brow Pencil, and this is a shade number 5. I'm going to quickly do the brows, and we're going to move on. To set my brow hairs in place, I'm using this Anastasia Beverly Hills Clear Brow Gel. This doesn't waterproof the eyebrows, it just makes the hair stay put without moving. Now moving on to complexion, I'm using my Fenty Beauty Face Primer, and this one is a smoothing one, just to help diminish the appearance of pores, get the skin ready. Now today, since I'm not going to use foundation, I'm using this Big Easy BB Cream in shade 3. By Benefit. It has SPF 35, so it's like a one-stop shop, especially nowadays. Spring and summer's gonna be right around the corner. I don't want to wear too much complexion product that it feels like it's gonna melt away. If you give it a rest of 2 minutes, it will set in and you'll see the color will adjust. I'm gonna set the face also with my Sephora Micro Smooth Powder in shade 25 medium with my MAC 134 face brush. I'm gonna set it all over, avoiding the center of my face because I'm gonna use a different powder for that. I'm using the Universal Sephora powder, it's just no color, using this brush I always use, which is the Hakuhodo Sephora Pro brush. And I'm gonna apply this just in the center of the face. This is gonna give it more of a brightening effect as well as setting it. Now for blush, I'm using MAC's Peony Petal. I'm just going to apply this to the apples of my cheeks using the Morphe M527 face brush. For eyeshadow today, I'm going to start off with this Charlotte Ronson shade Sherl. It is a wet eyeshadow. This is a throwback look, of course, using throwback items. And I'm using a Real Technique brush to blend that out. Now taking my old Sephora Pantone Emerald Green palette, I'm using that green sparkly color with a dense flat brush. We're gonna apply it to the center of our eyelids and staying in mainly the eyelid area. I'm using a MAC 224, and I'm just gonna buff out the edges of that green just to have a smooth transition fade. Now from that palette, I'm taking this white color and we're going to apply it to our brow bone, as well as using it to clean up any excess eyeshadow. Now taking that Charlotte Ronson liquid shadow again, applying it to your lower lash line. I am going to use that 224 to blend that green into the lower lash line as well, but do notice that I did not blend it right onto the lash line, I blended right underneath that green that we used from the Charlotte Ronson. Now I'm going to apply that same color onto the eyelid, just into center of the eyelid area to give it that contoured effect. So I went ahead and applied falsies, and for blending my lashes, I'm using this little miniature fresh mascara. Now for our cheeks, we're going to use Anastasia's Contour Kit, the original. And we're using the center color, which is called Fawn, I believe. Now taking the Becca Jaclyn Hill collab, this one is the Trio. Using the Champagne Pop and the lighter white shade mixed together, we're gonna highlight our face. Don't forget your nose and your Cupid's bow, anywhere that you want a little bit more pulled out, more definition, balanced. The chemistry was not enough. Make sure you blend out everything, your contour, a little bit of your cheekbone area as well. Now for lips, I'm taking this old NYX Echo shade. I never used this. I had one before years ago. I used it up and I bought a new one and I never used it again. So I want to balance this out with this bold green eye. Using Spice Lip Liner, I'm going to line my lips after I apply the lipstick just because I want the most minimal of the lip liner and more so the lipstick. We are going to blend the lips together by using the Kylie Cosmetics Cocoa Lip Gloss. I believe this one's called Damn Gina. It's a beautiful color. Now to set everything in place, I'm using my e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Set. I'm going to mist this all over. And that completes our Throwback Thursday tutorial. I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good day. Bye.